In this section, we're going to discuss supply, demand, and equilibrium. Now, supply and demand is probably one of the phrases most associated with economics because it really is the core of price theory, which is one of the greatest accomplishments of economics. So let's start with supply. Supply is a relationship between prices and quantities that sellers are willing to sell at those prices. Now, for something to be considered part of what sellers are willing to sell, they have to both have the good, that is, must be available to them, and they also must be willing to sell it at a particular price. Now, supply is a relationship. So when we display this relationship, we have to have a number of prices available to us and a number of quantities that are made available for sale at those prices. We can display this relationship in a supply schedule. A supply schedule is just a table showing us a list of prices and a list of quantities that are supplied by suppliers in the market. So here in this case, for this good, at a price of $0, our suppliers aren't willing to provide any of the good. The quantity supplied is 0. At a price of $5, they're willing to supply 100. At $10, they're willing to provide 200 for sale. At $15, they're willing to provide 300. And at $20, they're willing to provide 400. Now, we can also take this information and put it in a graphical form. The graphical form we call a supply curve. Now, often the supply curve is actually the preferred form, simply because it is so much faster for us to draw the curve, and the curve actually contains more information. So to draw this supply curve, just take the information that we had in the table and put it on a graph. So first, we have this point where the price is 0 and the quantity that is provided for sale is 0. Another point where the price is $5 and quantity is 100. Price of $10, quantity of 200. Price of 15, quantity of 300. And a price of $20 with a quantity of 400. Looks like these have a very nice line to them, so we'll just connect them. And that's our supply curve. Now, one thing we notice, both in the supply schedule and the supply curve, we follow what we call the law of supply. The law of supply tells us that ceteris paribus, that is, all other things equal, as price increases, the quantity supplied also increases, or at the very least does not decrease. Now, to a certain degree, this shouldn't be shocking. After all, if I'm willing to sell something for $10, I certainly should be willing to sell it to you for $15. That's far better for me as the seller. And at the same time, we do also understand and that at least does not decrease, because it might be that I'm not willing to provide any more of the good, or maybe I just don't have it available to provide. But at the very least, I will be willing to provide at a higher price anything that I'm willing to provide at a lower price. Another important distinction is between supply and quantity supplied. Supply always describes a relationship between prices and quantities. That being the case, it doesn't make any sense to say that supply went from 200 to 300. Neither 200 nor 300 are a relationship. So, anytime we say, for example, that supply changes, it means that a relationship changed. Not just the number provided, but the relationship between prices and quantities that are provided for sale at those prices changed. So this number is what we call quantity supplied. So it is perfectly fine to say the quantity supplied went from 300 to 100. That's perfectly acceptable. The quantity supplied is just the amount that is made available for sale at any particular point. So quantity supplied is not a relationship. Supply is a relationship. Another important point that comes out of this is that supply, that is that relationship between prices and quantities supplied, is not affected by prices. That is, that relationship will not change just because prices changed. Now, quantity supplied will be affected by prices. That's, after all, what the law of supply tells us. At higher prices, a greater quantity will tend to be supplied. Now, turning to the demand side. The demand side is going to feel extremely familiar because it's really just taking all of these concepts from the supply side but applying them to buyers rather than sellers. So demand is defined as a relationship between prices and quantities that buyers are willing to buy at those prices. This requires both the ability to afford the price and also the willingness to pay it. So it doesn't make any sense, for example, to say that I have any kind of demand for a Lamborghini at the kinds of prices that would normally be charged for that. I don't have the ability to afford that price, even if I might want a Lamborghini. So demand is really about your willingness and ability to pay for the thing. Here we have a demand schedule. Now, we'd imagine with the demand schedule that at very low prices, people would want to have a lot of the good. If we're giving away this good for free, people might want to take, say, 300 of them. Once we start charging, say, $5, that's going to scare some people away. Right? Some people might just not be willing to pay $5 for the good. Others might be unable to afford the $5 for that good. Either way, as price increases, we see a drop in the quantity supplied. Now, an important point here is that we notice quantity supplied didn't fall by the same amount each time. There's absolutely no reason that it would have to. Now, this does have an effect when we go to the supply curve and try to draw it. So at a price of $0, we were willing to buy 300 and able to buy 300. At a price of $5, that dropped to 250. At a price of $10, it dropped to 200. At a price of $15, it dropped even faster, down to 100, and at $20, we're unwilling to buy this at all. So if we connect this, we end up with a demand curve that has something of a kink in it, or we might possibly have drawn this more in a curved way. Either way, we can see demand isn't necessarily a straight line, nor supply for that matter. This is just making that concrete. One thing we do know about demand is that it will always follow the law of demand. That is, ceteris paribus, or all other things equal, as price increases, the quantity demanded will decrease, or at the very least, it won't increase. That is, as things become more expensive, we become less willing to buy them, or less able to afford them. As a result, we buy less, or at the very least, no more. We also make the distinction between demand and quantity demanded, very much like we do with supply, demand always being a relationship, while quantity demanded is just a number. So once again, it doesn't make any sense to say that demand is 300. That doesn't make sense. Now, the quantity demanded may be 300. In the next section, we'll take supply and demand, we'll bring them together, and build the argument for equilibrium as being the source of prices.